So next, what is chip? So chip is an integrated circuit, a piece of semiconductor material with many micro miniature circuits are integrated on it. The other name for the chip is also integrated circuit. What are the different techniques used to solve Boolean expression? The Boolean expression, we can solve it by 1 by Boolean laws or rules. Second one is by K-map. Third one is by, in K-map you have SOP and POS. Third one is by EVM. Fourth one is by Q-map. Fifth one is by PLD, Programmable Logical Device, such as PLA, Programmable Logical Array, or Programmable Array Logic, PAL. The next question is, what is K-map and what is EVM? K-map is the visual representation of SOP and POS, sum of product and product of sum. So what is EVM? EVM is nothing but alternative to the K-map. So EVM, what we are doing is, it is called as entered variable map. One of the variable is expressed in output, or one of the variable is we will mention the variable in the map itself, inside the map itself. That's why it is called as entered variable map, or map entered variable. So that is the definition. Next one is a define SOP. SOP is nothing but sum of product, and POS is nothing but product of sum. SOP means SOP and miniterms. Miniterms means one more question is there. Miniterms. Miniterms are the terms which represent one in the truth table. That is called as miniterm. Also, it is also called as sum of product. And max term are the terms in truth table which represent zero, which is also called as POS. So now, what is POS? POS is the logical product of those fundamental sums that produce output 1 in the truth table. And SOP is the logical sum of those fundamental products that produce the output 1 in the truth table. So this is the difference between SOP equation and POS equation. So SOP, normally SOP expression, we will express something like this function of 4 variable A, B, C, D, and C, D, and summation M, and we represent miniterms here, miniterms like 1, 2, which represent 1 in the truth table, corresponding 1 in the truth table, and this one, max terms we represent by using SOP, POS we represent by using pi M, which represent actually 0, which represent 0 in the truth table. So now explain the benefits of larger grouping. By using larger grouping, you can reduce the number of variables in the output expression. For example, if I use a 4 variable group, so 4 variable map, then if I take individual, then there will be four literals or 4 variables. Individual cell, then will be 4 variables. If I take if I group number of two like pair, then output will be 3 variable expression. If I group 4 numbers of ones, then output will be 2 variable expression. Then if I group 8 number of ones, then output will be a single literal or single variable. So that is the advantage, because you can implement the circuit with less number of gates if you go for larger grouping. What is the advantage of Q-map over K-map? So first one is K-map. Actually, it is fine for number of variables 4. Once the number of variable increases, then it is difficult for grouping and all. Then the grouping in the K-map, it depends on the user ability. So user ability. So one user can group in one way and other user can group in another way. So user ability. So all these things can be overcome by Q-map. So in HDL, what is the data flow? What is the gate level? And what is the behavioral modeling? See, gate level means we can represent the circuit by using a gate. We will directly call gate functions. Data flow modeling means we will use, instead of a gate level, we will use some of the statements like assign, etc. Statements, and we will execute. And behavioral modeling means we will use some of the statements in sequential order, which will execute in sequential order. That is example if else, etc. That is called as a behavioral modeling. Why don't care conditions are used while solving Boolean expressions? So sometimes in the truth table, for the certain input condition, there won't be any output exist, or there won't be any output occurs. Such type of conditions are called as don't care conditions. And we represent this one by using X, and you can use this one while solving Boolean expression, and you can use this either 1 or 0 depending on the situation. What do you mean by test bench? Test bench means giving input waveform, giving waveform as input to the simulation circuit, and calling thereby functions or modules and executing it and producing the output waveform, that is called as a test bench, or nothing but simulating, it is called as test bench. What is hazard? Hazard is nothing but a type of glitches in the circuit for the variation in the processing delay or delays in the gates, etc. So that is called as hazard. There are two types of hazards are there. One is called as static zero hazard. Other one is called static one hazard. Static zero hazard means actually always a into a bar should be always zero, but due to delay it becomes one. That's why during the transition from zero to one, this hazard occurs. And static one hazard means a plus a bar should be always one, but due to certain problem it becomes a zero. So this occurs during the OR gate, and this occurs in the AND gate. So this is the static zero hazard and static one hazard. So this is the one.